Rowandale School in Manurewa takes pride in its firm stance against fizzy drinks.
What we do is we encourage children to bring water.
Like many primary schools nationwide, Rowandale has implemented its own policy to ban the consumption of sugary drinks during school hours.
Just making sure that our children are healthy, that our children's teeth are good, that they're making these choices and they're not becoming diabetic or, you know, obese before they should.
Now the government wants this policy extended to all primary schools, allowing only water, milk and non-dairy alternatives instead, a proposal praised by Pacific health experts.
We have the highest rates of childhood obesity, but a lot of people don't know we've also got the highest rates of dental caries for our young children.
It's good to see that the government are finally doing something about sugary drinks again.
Auckland University lecturer Dr. Gerhard Sunderborn is a member of the New Zealand Beverage Guidance Panel and has spent nearly a decade advocating for water-only schools.
In New Zealand, over 8,500 children require general anaesthetic, which means that they'll be put to sleep to get multiple tooth extractions each year in New Zealand. And we know a high proportion of our Pasifika kids make up that number.
The proposal is currently open for public consultation and will take effect next year if it goes through.
I think Pacific parents will embrace this. I think, you know, they're aware that sugary drinks are not good for their children's health and learning as well.
If they saw the terrible state of some of our children's teeth and dentition, then they would agree with this. But it needs to come with community education as well.
Carl urges parents to get on board, but says the transition to water could also prove tricky for some families.
Sometimes a bottle of water is more expensive than a fizzy drink. And so a lot of our families, you know, they struggle sometimes to make ends meet.
There's evidence to show that switching from full sugar soft drinks and things to the zero sugar versions, there are health benefits. So that's a step in the right direction. But, you know, water and unflavoured milk are the best options overall.
And I think it's important that if their children are to be healthy and, you know, have better outcomes and better concentration and, you know, just live full lives so that they can also make good choices in the future, that I think it's important that our parents also understand these reasons and connect and try and make a change.